can you fulfill sort of what is needed and what is desired by a graduate med school program in online course offerings?
My name is Karina Macosco from Academic Influence, and I am here with Brian Teasdale, and we are focusing on another online program, but this one is for undergrad, a bachelor's degree, and so I'm really excited to hear about this, and we just want to start out with, how did your program get started, and what was kind of the original goal and vision for that?
Sure. First of all, thanks for having me on. I'm always excited to talk about our programs. So, you know, our university, like a lot of universities, was starting to build up its online course offerings. So we had envisioned some of our courses and how they would translate as an online course, and had developed one course before 2020, and that was a medical terminology course. It was something that worked very well in an online environment. But then all of a sudden the pandemic hits, and here we were, and especially me, because I manage our biology faculty, and we have a fair number of 12-month biology faculties who work year-round, and I was basically in a situation in which I would have a lot of faculty that wouldn't have anything to do during the summer months. Because our institution had gone fully online through the pandemic. And so we all got together and said, well, how do we utilize this time effectively for our institution and for our students? And we decided to work with our online school. We have a school of online learning, and spent the summer developing a fully online Bachelor's of Arts in biology degree program. And so that was really sort of the biggest hurdle was really the how we do the labs. I mean, as in science, if anybody's taken a chemistry or a biology course, you know, the one thing you can kind of remember about the class is your lab experience, you know, kind of going in and touching the frog or, you know, bubbling up some chemical in the chemistry lab. And so how would we be able to develop something that fulfills all the required learning objectives and give a very rewarding experience for these students? And so that was a challenge, but unlike 10 years ago where I would have said, well, there's no way we're going to be able to do this, we've advanced so much in the way of virtual technology and virtual learning that all the tools were there. And so we, in some cases, we developed our own sort of lab tutorials, but we also contracted with external virtual lab companies in order to fulfill that need.
Wow, that's awesome. And when creating this program, did you have a target audience in mind? A lot of the online programs we've talked to are kind of people who are going back to school and maybe have kids or a life that they can't go up and move somewhere to complete an online degree. So what was kind of your target audience in mind when you created this program?
Yeah, great question. So our target audience was really, it's like you said, we were kind of looking at students who wouldn't normally be, would easily have access to our in-person kind of environment. So we were definitely looking for non-traditional students was an audience, full-time working students. And so it's unusual. That was sort of how we envisioned it. We really didn't envision it for, and we kind of wanted to stay away from students who were looking at graduate clinical programs. So, 'cause there's, and rightfully so, a lot of these graduate programs, so let's think of a physician assistant program or a doctorate of physical therapy program, they are targeting students that really have this kind of hands-on, in-person experience. You know, make sure that you hold the model of the muscle, that you are pulling apart different aspects of the nerves and the brain in an anatomy course. And to this day, we still sort of don't target this for those students because we're afraid that there may be a bias in the graduate application process of having online courses and that that might hurt them as they apply for a graduate program. But of course, with the pandemic and almost almost every institution going virtual, this isn't going to be an aspect that's going to count against students, at least in the near future. But it is something I think when it comes to online learning that people will be looking at a lot in the future. Can you fulfill sort of what is needed and what is desired by a graduate med school program in online course offerings? So it's going to be a really exciting time in the next 5 years in online learning, I think.
Yeah, and that's such an interesting point you bring up, because we've asked a few of the other people we've had on here for online programs if they've seen kind of a difference in what people are willing to hire, whether you get your degree online or in person. And so for bachelor's program, is it different, especially not only for employment, but if you're planning to get a degree after that? Have you seen differences in who they're willing to accept?
We haven't seen differences, and it'll be interesting to see whether we're going to somehow be teased out when it sort of in. I always think of institutional research, sort of how an institution sort of tracks its students. Right now, our students are sort of tagged as either online or as an in-person student, but their degree is the same. So their degree does not say BA Biology online or BA Biology in person, because our accrediting body and our requirements for our course is the same. And so we've met the criteria for the learning objectives for each course. And so they're fulfilling what is needed by an institution of higher learning to fulfill that aspect of their degree. So whether there's an asterisk down in the future, you know, I think of like baseball, when they were going through, you know, should we put asterisks next to people's names? But whether there should be an asterisk that this is a fully online degree program or not, I don't know. It's good. Once again, we're kind of in uncharted territory here for us when it comes to a science degree being fully online. Right now, I believe we are the only fully online biology degree program in the state of New Jersey. And so it'll be interesting to see how the state of New Jersey and our accrediting body kind of looks at online degrees and how we need to identify ourselves.
Wow, yeah, and a lot of these programs are so new, which makes them exciting. It's a great option for people, especially if they can't go back into school. But like you said, it's also uncharted territory. And so we did get a good comparison of traditionally in-person classes and online degrees when everything had to go online. So coming out of the pandemic, how do you think it was for something that had been set up as an online degree compared to an in-person learning that just had to move really quickly online? Did you see a difference in what people were learning?
We did. So our online courses, the one that we developed fully online, were just much more organized. A lot of our courses that were our in-person courses that sort of stayed as in-person. So when Kean University went through pandemic, so besides having these fully asynchronous online courses for our online degree program, our in-person courses went what we call a modality of being remote. In other words, they still met at the same times. And so everybody had their cameras on, they met, and they went through it just like their in-person class. That's very different than our asynchronous online degree program. Our online degree program is fully asynchronous. That means you don't have to meet at any day or time. And so most of this is done through discussion groups at a student's own pace on a week-to-week basis. And so it was very, very different, but very, very organized. And so if a student was very organized, they really liked our fully online courses. If a student really kind of wanted to keep sort of how they were doing things in person on campus, then our remote modality where they still met at the same times. We continued doing our labs in person during the pandemic. So our students still came on. They had an option. So they could either take our remote labs, which we use in our fully online courses, or they could come on in person on campus. And so our students had an option the entire time we were in the pandemic.
Wow, that is impressive. And I think you kind of touched on what I like to ask people is who would really benefit from an online degree versus an in-person degree? And it kind of sounds like you pointed that out. If they were very organized, then it might be better for them to do the fully asynchronous. And if they kind of needed more of that structure, it's better for them to go in person. Would you agree?
100%. I mean, that we were finding, especially if a student who's not organized or needs some supplementary help, they may have a deficiency in math or just needed that extra touch, it was a lot easier to get still in an in-person environment because there's just more time with the instructor. But if you're a person who's very focused, very organized, this type of student does very, very well in our fully online asynchronous format. It's not for everybody. And I think that's what we were looking for is how do we give our students more options? So we have an option of in-person where you get sort of that constant touch by the faculty member, sort of that constant interaction, and you could always go to them for help. But if you're a person who really doesn't need a lot of that extra help and you're very organized, our online works very, very well because then you kind of set your own time management on how you're going to complete that course. And so the fact that we had two options and said, students, which works for you, choose the option, move forward with it. I think it was an advantage for us as an institution, and it was perfect timing for us at least.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that flexibility is really key. Just giving students more options of what fits their lifestyle, especially people who are trying to go back to get a degree and maybe don't have like the traditional student life where they can just leave everything and go to class. And I think even that point of it won't work for every student, that is really key to emphasize because we've talked to people who are even college admissions officers for fully in-person colleges, and they say the same thing. You know, every college, even if you're comparing to in-person colleges, they're just not going to work for everyone. So you really have to find what works for you. And so we've kind of looked back to how the program got started and as it moved through the pandemic. And so now I just want to look forward. What do you see in the future for not only your program, but programs like it in the future? I mean, right now you said you're the only fully online biology bachelor's in New Jersey. And so do you think we'll see more of these? I mean, I'm guessing the answer is probably yes, but in what sense do you think we'll continue to see more online programs?
I think 100% we're going to be seeing more online programs. We're going to see more online courses even at our institution. The one thing I didn't mention is we set this up program specifically for a student to come into the program and be an online student. But what I didn't say is that for spaces, so let's say we have in a course 24 spots, and 20 of those spaces going into the fall semester are these online students. Those remaining spots are coveted by our in-person students. So we'll have some in-person students, and they'll say, I just can't organize my schedule, but if I take this online course, this one single online course, all of a sudden my schedule gets very easily. I can work around my work schedule. And so it's our in-person students are now demanding more flexibility in kind of dual modalities. They want to be in person, but they also want the options to be taking some of these online courses as well. We're going to be developing more online courses. And I think it's really kind of getting there's a bias out there, I think, even in higher education with faculty and administrators, that online learning can't be equivalent to an in-person experience. And I think that faculty have to kind of take a look at technology and where we've come, and I disagree. I think we can do amazing things online that we couldn't do in the past, and we need to start embracing that technology because I think it works for our students. It can't always just be what works for the school or the faculty. We have to bring the student perspective, and right now I think the student feedback has been, we want more. And if that's the feedback, then we need to adjust and adapt to that desire in order to grow. And that's kind of where we're looking right now.
Wow, yeah, and it has just been so interesting to hear about your program, and I really like the fact that you brought up the quality of education that can be offered with online. And so just wrapping up the interview, this is kind of a little off topic, but I am certainly very interested in it, and I hope a lot of people are out there. Do you think we'll see some of the highly competitive universities coming out with more online programs? I mean, part of the reason we've seen this trend of colleges getting increasingly more competitive in admissions. And so do you think if some of the higher schools, maybe the Ivies or like the top public universities, come out with online programs, do you think it would make it less competitive? And do you think they would still be able to offer the same quality of education?
Yes, a lot of them already are. You know, I think of, and I just want to throw out some names because we kind of looked at some of these programs as a model for when we were developing ours. And, you know, the University of Florida is doing wonderful things in online learning, University of Arizona. And, you know, we talk Ivies. Harvard has actually been one of the first universities that really kind of came out and embraced online environment and sort of short courses online. And so I think a lot of these schools are there and they're ramping up now. I think the pandemic is pushing us to move a little bit faster. I think schools that weren't embracing this before the pandemic are playing a lot of catch up. And so and that's causing a lot of frustration. But you know, you're seeing jobs out there for what we call instructional designers for online course development. I mean, boy, if you're in this field right now, you're going to be very busy. So it's a pretty exciting time in that area of education. So I 100% believe that universities will need to embrace it and grow it in order to survive and grow.
Wow. Well, thank you for that. And yeah, I'm really excited as a student, and I'm sure you are as an educator, to see where online school takes us, because especially with the pandemic, I feel like it's just accelerated this process of moving things online. And I think you are absolutely right that we will continue to see more online programs in the future. So thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us. It was really fun to just hear about your program and hear your thoughts on online programs in general. So thank you so much.
Well, thanks for having us.